Hello everyone, and today we are going to be reacting to Eternal Sunshine by Ariana Grande. One of you left this comment on my YouTube video for Hit Me Hard and Soft, for that reaction video. If you haven't seen it, go check it out. I am not an Ariana listener. I have barely listened to really any of her albums. I know like the singles, like Thank You, Next, Yes, and I'm excited. I'm excited because I am getting to experience new music, and I think that this YouTube channel doing reactions, but specifically music reactions, is allowing me to really explore new music just from people's tastes and stuff, and I'm really excited. So I'm not gonna keep it that much longer. I think we should just jump in. Let's do it. Track number one, intro, in parentheses, end of the world. Oh, that's pretty.
I cannot tell if I'm in the right relationship. Aren't you really supposed to know that shit? Feel it in your bones and own that shit. Either if the moon went dark tonight, and if it all ended tomorrow, would I be the one in your mind? Your mind.
The harmonies are already beautiful. That was a really cute intro track. Track number two, Bye. I just love the, like, that background.
This ain't the first time I've been hostage to these things.
That is so fun.
So I grab my stuff, Courtney just pulled up.
Hey, Courtney. I know this part. Yo, that background track, like that background, like instrumental, is crazy. Bye. Yeah, that is a catchy chorus. I will say, the one thing I've noticed about Ariana, which, again, like I said, I don't listen to her a lot, but what I have listened to, her choruses always are super catchy. And every time it's on the radio, I'm like, I'm gonna listen to this whole thing because it's just really catchy. So this is one of the songs where it's like, I had never heard anything else except for the boy or the bye bye boy bye. But every time I see that bye bye boy bye, it's so catchy and I want to sing along to it every time. The rest of the song so far is so good too. Like that background instrumental track is so satisfying. Ooh, not the key change. Like, you just want to get up and dance with it, you know? That is, wow. I've never heard that full song, and holy shit, that song is crazy. Track number three, Don't Wanna Break Up Again. You know, people have always made fun of like Arianators and like the people who like really enjoy Ariana Grande's voice. And me growing up with like Victorious and stuff, I always thought her, like, if I'm being completely honest, I always thought Kat was really annoying. But her voice has grown so much since then, and it's such a soothing, like, buttery voice. That mixed with this track, it really feels like mixed with like the sounds on this album, it really feels like sunshine just in your ears. And it just sounds so good and so like comforting, you know? Her voice is so good. So good.
Day in the morning, so I take my time to self-soothe. I'm too anxious, but I just can't refuse. I don't know.
That little, like, is so, that was such a nice little touch.
I made it so easy, spent so much on therapy, blame my own codependency, but ooh, you didn't even try, refuse, I don't wanna break up again,
this song is so sad. You're dating this person and you guys are like, it just feels like a situationship because you guys are constantly breaking up, so you guys aren't really committed, but you keep it's such a good song. Bye was really catchy, but the chorus and the lead-in to the chorus in this song was so smooth. Like, it just felt so much like butter. Like, it just felt like it was just flowing, you know? Like, it was just such a... Oh, that was such a good track. Such a good track. We're gonna do track 4 and 5 together since this is only 42 seconds long. It's like a little interlude. So we're gonna do both songs. So this is tracks 4 and 5, Saturn Returns Interlude, Eternal Sunshine. So we are going to do this together. So let's just take it in.
When we're all born, Saturn's somewhere. And the Saturn cycle takes around about 29 years. Hits you over the head, hits you over the head, hits you over the head and says, wake up! It's time for you to get real about life and sort out who you really are.
Mm. Whoa. Ooh, I was not expecting that.
I don't care what people say. We both know I couldn't change you. I guess you could say the same.
Mm.
Can't rearrange truth. Get me out of this loop.
Oh. The interlude and this is like just the way the song connects is so good too, because obviously it was talking about how you have to find out who you really are, and you know, until you find out who you really are, you're going through so many relationships, you're meeting so many people, and eventually you're gonna find out who you are, but also you're gonna find out like the type of people you want to surround yourself with. And like, you're going to stop lying to yourself. You're going to stop receiving bullshit from other people who are just causing suffering in your life. And it's such a... Oh, my God. This one's so good, too. This one's really good, too.
Yeah, so now we play our separate scenes. Now she's in my bed, laying on your chest. Now I'm in my head, wondering how it ends.
Mm. Oh, the little... Dude, the harmony on that's crazy. I love the like it just was so, that's so catchy. That is such like a, and it was so like ethereal. Like, you just, oh my God, that was so good. Is it, I can see what that's the title track. Amazing. That song was so good. The push and pulls, the flowing of the choruses and into like the bridge and the like the verses, so good. It's probably right now, that's my number one, that song. Track number 6, Supernatural.
It's crystal clear and I want you to come claim it. I do. What are you waiting for? Yeah, want you to name it. I do. Want you to make it yours.
Okay, real quickly before we get into like, I'm assuming what's the chorus. Her voice sounds so good in the lower register. Obviously, we all know she can hit the high notes and the really, really, really high notes. But watching her lean into her lower, or listening to her lean into her lower register of her voice is such a satisfying, warm sound. Like, it feels like you're sitting out in the sun, like, tanning.
Need your hands on up on my body.
Mm.
Like the moon needs the stars.
Imagine somebody talking to you like this and told me that they needed my hands all up on their body like the moon needs the stars. I would say right now this is probably my least favorite on the album. It's not bad in any sense. It's a great song. The chorus just didn't really hit with me. I was trying to like kind of like feel it, and I just couldn't really like feel it as well. The vocals though in the end were fucking amazing. The runs were crazy. But overall, I think that this is probably going to be towards the bottom. But we'll see after the album, like, you know, how I feel. But right now, it's not bad. It's just not my favorite. Track number 7, True story. Okay, 30 seconds in, and that literally did something to my body. That was crazy. Somebody please just give this woman love. That one made me tired. That one made me weary. Those runs, the vocal range alone in that song, going from, like, her ability to go from so low to so high in such a short amount of time is so amazing. Track number 8, The Boy Is Mine. Oh. How can it be you and me? My people to be, can't unsee it. Baby, come over, come over. Oh my god, are you kidding me? That was amazing. That was so good. So good. I'm trying. This one makes me want to shake ass. This one makes me want to shake ass. And if it doesn't make you want to shake ass, I'm so sorry for you. Ooh. Ah. The title, The Boy Is Mine, might as well be talking about me. Because that shit grabbed me by my man tits and just straight up like was like, just shake ass. That was crazy. It's gotta be at least one song I don't like. And as I say that, we get to the track in which I probably got out of my seat and started like running around the room because I thought it was so good. And I know there's a lot of people who don't like this song. Y'all be fucking tripping because this song bangs so hard. Crack. Track number 10. We Can't Be Friends. In parentheses, Wait for Your Love. How could you ever even try? Oh, I love her voice on this one. Her voice in that intro was so pretty. It just, like, it felt like you wanted to, like, give her a hug. Oh my god, that was so pretty. Yeah, I've heard this. That production is insane too. Me and my truth, we sit in silence. Oh my god, I could listen to her sing like this. Baby girl, it's just me and you. Oh, the silence, the pause, the pause. Me and my truth, we sit in silence. Oh my god. We can't be friends, but I'd like to just pretend. You cling to your papers and pens. Wait until you like me again. Wait until you like me again. You cling to your papers and pens. Wait until you like me again. That chorus is so hauntingly beautiful and catchy. Oh, not the instrumental outro. That outro, that instrumental outro could have just kept going for like another like 20 minutes and I would have been okay with it. That song was so fucking pretty. I have heard the chorus somewhere. I don't know if it was TikTok or if it was somewhere else, but I've heard it somewhere. But I have not heard the rest of that song, and holy shit, was that so beautiful. We're on track 11, I Wish I Hated You. I wish you were worse to me. Oh my god, stop. Just cut it out, please. Jesus, cutting my fucking heart up. Oh my god. So close to you, so far, so funny. We had on from the start. That is such like an entrancing, just get lost in that. Like, I just want to keep going with that. The melody in the background is making it feel like a phone call. Like, it feels like I'm like you're on the phone with her and she's saying this to you, like, we're breaking up or we have broken up. She's saying like, you weren't a terrible person. We're breaking up because we don't click and, you know, we just didn't work out, but I can't say I hated you. It would make my life easier telling myself that I did hate you. It would make me feel better knowing I hated you, but I don't. And that's what makes this hurt so much. That track was so simple, but it had one of the best. I think it had one of the best lyrics. Like, I could listen to her read poetry to me like that. I love that track. That was so nice. Track number 12, Imperfect For You. It's so good. Ooh. She sounds so good here. Oh, right there. That little usually I'm, that is so pretty. You said usually I'm fucked up when we ain't feeling fucked up, anxious. The drop into that is so, sorry, the drop into that is so satisfying. When we ain't feeling fucked up, anxious. A very fun song. It really worked, and I know this is gonna sound kind of stupid, but it really worked because of the Imperfect For You kind of giving it that weird little feel to it. It separates itself from the rest of the album, but it makes it its own thing that you can kind of like, you can pinpoint on the album where the song is, specifically because the song just sounds not too different from the rest of the album, but different enough so that it stands out. And I really like that song. I thought it was really good. Track number 13, the final track, Ordinary Things, featuring Nana? Nona? Nana? Is this her grandmother? I don't know who this is. Right away, the use of the horns is so pretty. I love that. I love that choice for the final song to start it like this. Oh, I'm already in it. We could go pop all the champagne in California. We could spend every dime, but I don't want anything but more time. That is such a good, we could do all these things. I don't give a shit if I'm broke by the end of it. I just want to spend more time with you. I just want to keep spending time with you. I don't give a fuck if it makes me poor. No matter what we do, there's never gonna be an ordinary thing. No ordinary things for you. What we have is extraordinary. As long as we're together, it may sound funny, it may sound cliche. But you and I, what we have, it will never be ordinary. Oh my god.
That is like one of the best feelings on the planet. You hit every green light and it just feels like you're zooming.
And when he'd come home and I'd see him and the physical gets off that train, It was like God Almighty arrived. It was like seeing daylight. I mean, I could have packed up and left a million times, you know. Yeah. Never go to bed without kissing goodnight. It's the worst thing to do. Don't ever, ever do that. And if you can't, and if you don't feel comfortable doing it, you're in the wrong place. Get out.
Aw. Aw. That was like the cutest ending to an album I think I've ever heard in my life. I loved that track. I loved this album. I think Supernatural might be the one that I like the least. I don't hate it and I don't not like it in any way. I just think I like it the least compared to everything else. I think the whole album was so strong. This last track really, like, I'm assuming that's like her grandmother or someone close to her and her family who's older. Using that really conveys the name of the album, The Eternal Sunshine, kind of, you know, when we're kids. Unfortunately, both my grandparents are passed, but growing up, you know, as a kid, like, you just love your grandparents so much. They just bring this like light into your life, and I really think that that last part of the song really kind of just like drove the whole point of the album home. You love someone so much that it just feels like sunshine. It just feels like warmth on your skin, like every day. Yeah, it was just a really beautiful album in general. The whole album just really felt very cohesive. As someone who has never listened to like a whole Ariana album, I was pleasantly surprised. I'll be curious if you guys want me to check out other Ariana albums in the future. You know, you guys can always let me know in the comments down below. But I really appreciated this album. I don't know how to describe it, but it kind of this album kind of makes me emotional in a couple ways, like the way I feel about my own partner and the way I feel about family in general, and it really got me thinking. So I really like this album, and I hope you guys like the reaction. Let me know what you guys think in the comments down below. Let me know what you guys want to see me react to next. But love you guys. Let me know what you guys think, and I will see you guys in the next one. Bye bye.